in a few minutes with another one for you to enjoy.
Two men have become fast friends, and the bond between them centers around the 1966 Mustang convertible. One is original from the bottom up, and the other isn't. But you could never tell the difference the way these two friends have pored over their prized possessions. The Mustang, probably one of the sexiest convertibles ever made for the American automotive market, was originally the brainchild of legendary car maker Lee Iacocca, and credited with introducing to Ford a new image that would last for decades to come.
Brick May, I've got a 66 coupe. It's got a 289A code in it, which means it's 2 1/4 horse with 4-barrel, automatic. It's got air conditioning, factory power disc brakes. It's all original, except for the color. It was an antique bronze car instead of the candy apple red. The red looks a lot better than the bronze and stuff. So we kind of changed the color a little bit, but other than that, it is all original. It's got all original sheet metal on it, original floorboards in it. It come out of California. I bought it off the original owner and took a 2.5-year ground up restoration on it. My brother had called me on a Saturday morning, and he lived in Ohio, and he told me that one of the local Mustang dealerships down there that restores Mustangs and everything had my car down there. And I said, well, what do you mean they got my car? Well, they've got a 66, and I know you've been looking for one, and it's rust-free. And I think you ought to come down and look at it, because if you come down and look at it, you're going to take it home with you. So I told my wife, I said, well, let's go. We're going on a road trip. And we jumped in the car a half an hour later, and we're heading to Ohio. I looked it all over, liked what I seen, and told the guy I wanted to take it home with me. So he says, well, I take cashier's checks or checks or whatever. So I gave him $3,000 for it, and we pushed it on the car trailer with a tractor. When I got to my brother's house with it, we tried to see if it'd run, and it did run and everything. Drove it home, and that's where it started.
It's just that drop everything and go spirit that epitomizes enthusiasts for the Ford Mustang. The Mustang is synonymous with youth and style, and its appeal crosses age barriers to keep it alive into the new century.
I guess the reason I love the Mustang is because when I was growing up in that's what I had the most of. I mean, my first one was a 64.5 convertible, and then I got rid of that and had a 70. And there's nothing like driving down the road at 70 mile an hour with the windows down and being a one-man car show as you're going down the road. Everybody waving at you and thumbs up, you know, and think you got a cool car and everything, and you kind of know you do.
For Jack Wolf, the story is nearly the same, but his passion with the Mustang extends to the convertible version.
Well, I've always kind of been a convertible person. I never owned one before I started getting into Mustangs. There's nothing like driving out, especially late at night. I'll take the thing out before I go to bed. Quite often, I'll pop the top and head out with it and tear up the belt line and back a little faster than I probably ought to, but it's just an incredible feeling. You're out there and it's dark and you can see the sky, and it's just incredible.
And Jack's third Mustang means he's never too experienced to learn something new.
Well, this is my, I guess, it's third Mustang I've owned. A few years ago, I was in a position where I could finally get an old car. I've been a car nut ever since I can remember.
That's been too long.
I bought another red 66 convertible. It was a 6-cylinder. It was in pretty nice shape. I had that for 3-4 years, and I stumbled on a 69 Cougar down in Kalamazoo during the winter at a swap meet. I picked that car up pretty inexpensively, and I hadn't driven a V8 in so many years. I just had forgotten what they were like. So it kind of got me excited, and I decided to sell them both, and I went looking for another V8 convertible.
And something new extended to his mission to getting the car back home.
I happened to find this one in Mustang and Ford Trader, It was owned by some people in Richmond, Virginia. A buddy of mine in Indiana and I had gone out to pick the car up in Virginia, and the minute we got it on the trailer, it poured. And the guy I bought it from come running out of the house and says, you know, he says, that car's never seen water. Well, it's seen water now. But we drove home straight through back to Elkhart that night. And the next morning I drove home from Elkhart with it. I stopped to buy gas just on the outside of town. And when I left there, I got it stuck in second gear. I could not get it out. The four speed would not. It was all hung up in the linkages. I drove it home from Elkhart in second gear, taking back roads and clutching it real good and going slow.
Two men maintain their friendship using this very alive, very fast, and very beautiful Mustang as the common bond between them.
Hi, West Michigan. Once again, we are back at the first annual MetroCruise. We're out in the Cascade area here at the D&W Plaza. This time we